I left my fear by the side of the road. Hear you speak, you won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands to pray. God, every reason to be here again. Father's heart that draws me in. And all my eyes wanna see is a glimpse of you. All I need is you. Hallelujah, Jesus. That's all we need is the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And hallelujah, church. You know, it's always a blessing to be in the blessings of the Lord. Amen. It's always blessed to do also the will of the Lord. You know, I want to share with you, church, about giving. Amen. We give of ourselves. Because we give unto the Lord. Amen. There has to be an order of things. Amen. That has to take place. And see what is important in your life. Amen. What's important to God as well in your life. To give of ourselves. Amen. Not only to the work of the ministry, church, but as well to our families and to our loved ones and to sharing and into giving. Amen. Sometimes we could just be wrapped up so much, wrapped up around that tree and thinking about giving of gifts versus as well giving of ourselves. And, you know, that too takes time. That too takes prayer. And sometimes, yes, that does. It does. It takes a little bit of money, you know, because now we're giving of ourselves, you know. Maybe people, you didn't take time to be with this year. Maybe time will tell, you know. Things that you weren't able to do this year, amen. And so those are areas and spaces and places that God is saying, you know what, I want to shine in those areas too. You know, how is it that we're supposed to be examples to our loved ones, to our co-workers, or to our friends, or even to our children? Come on, I'm trying to be, I mean, make it really real here today. You know, if they don't see the Christ of life inside of you through your gestures, by the things that we do, by the things that we say, you know. And sometimes, you know, ministry, a call to ministry, you feel constantly like you're having to put family aside and put all else aside, you know, and putting God first. Well, putting God first is putting God where the heart of God is. Amen. And we can't forget that not only is God is in the heart of ministry, but also God's heart is for the family, church. You know, I've heard it said this way. There's a lot of ministers, you know, that became, you know, without a wife, without a family, that the family walked out on them, you know, or walked out on him, or walked out on her. Why? Because there was not that communion, that unity, that oneness to say, you know what, we are here. We are here. We're ever so here. We're ever so acknowledged. We are ever so prominent. We are ever so in the plus with the Lord of what He has for us to do. You know, it's great when God calls us out by the one. But it's such a blessing when He calls us out by the two. You know, there's work to be done. Hallelujah. And sometimes, yes, you do have to jump over, fly over, you know, go over, you know, the things that bring you down, the things that pull you down, and connect with those things that pull you up. But when all reality, when everything's said and done, and when you've been shaked, come on now, when you've been baked, hallelujah, I mean toasted, you know, by the loved ones, by the friends, even by the family, I mean, there is God. There is God. You know, He calls us to a relationship with Him. He doesn't call us to a religion. He doesn't call us to a ministry. He doesn't call us to a family. He calls us to all those areas and perspectives. I'm not saying that they're deluded. No, I'm saying that putting God first is the key, because He's the one that's going to show you what to do in your day, what to do with your strength, what to do with your might, what to do with your mind, what to do with your body. You know what, church? We have to have a balance and a perspective life over and in our lives. You know, I've heard it said it this way: what good it is to gain the whole world, but to lose your very soul. You know, and that's what I'm sharing about with you here today. God loves you. He loves the sinner, but He hates the sin. And God is ever so for us in every place and every space and every perspective, that, you know what, God is willing to do that work over and in our lives. As we stay connected to Christ, as we stay connected unto the Lord, as we stay connected to the highways and to the byways and to the lost, to the hungry, to the weak, God sees our gestures. God knows our gestures. But God is well, church, is about family. God as well is about children. God as well is about our lives, our personal lives. God is so personal, church. He cares what we think as individuals. He cares that we think as a family. He cares of every matter and perspective of all of the areas in our lives. God wants us to continually to cruzar fronteras con una voz de alerta. You know, something today just moved upon heavily upon my heart today. And He's saying, you know what? Deliver the word. Deliver the word. God is going to begin to give you channels. And you know what? I receive that. I receive those channels. Hallelujah. Because God is the God of open doors. God is the God of perspection. He knows what our destiny is. And God is a God that is in control. You know what? We think of the remote control just a pop of the button. Just to put the volume high, put the volume low, or you know what, or change the channel going up, or change the channel going down. See, church, God knows all those areas of the going up and the going down. You know what? It's all in the same of the button that goes on and to the button that goes off. We're not talking about a controller that man controls, but we're talking about not the remote control of man, but the remote control of God. I know you probably never heard it like that, but I pray today that the realization that the same God that brings you up is the same God that can bring it down a notch. But it's not that He's going to leave you down. It's the port and the part where He says, you know what? This is where I'm going to launch you out even higher, because there's still areas of places and spaces that have to, they're not redundant, but that have to be secure, that have to know that, you know what? This is where the blessing is. This is where the blessing gives. This is where we are and where we find ourselves at this moment and at this time. You know, God is the one that gives me the word for the day. He says, I want you to share on this matter. It burns in my heart. It burns in my spirit. And it just comes ever so alive. This word is reaching unto the nations, to the north, the south, the east, to the west. I invite you to be a part of the subscribers on my YouTube. Amen. And those that are connecting, know that I'm doing live video in as well. We're fixing to come on in. Those that have Periscope, I believe it's a part of Twitter that it works off of. And so that video is going to go right there. And I'm just going to keep on sharing this gospel and allowing His word to be uplifted and to be praised. So this is what I want to share to the house of God today. If you're putting God first, great. Because that's what this is about. Putting God first. And you know what? It's having that content inside of you. It's not people putting their finger on you. It's not people what they think. What people think. It's what God has resonated in your heart to complete and to do. That is the fulfillment. That is the cause. That is the blessing. That is the realness of the Lord Jesus Christ in putting God first. So I love you, church. Keep on keeping the challenge, putting Jesus as Lord, and know that, yes, He is Lord. And you know what? You are the beloved. So we love you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name, be blessed today. Amen and amen.
I left my fear by the side of the road. Hear you speak, you won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands to pray. God, every reason to be here again. Father's heart that draws me in. And all my eyes want to see is a glimpse of you. All I need.